we do for a living is we extract core for mining companies. So it's we own diamond drills and we go out in the field and we do core extraction. Why it's called diamond drilling is because the bit that we use to cut the ground has got diamond chips in it. So what we're doing is defining the ore body, which is a different kind of drilling. I have a lot of inspirations from a child. My mother was a huge role model. She was, that's part of my success, where another part of my success is people I meet in the industry growing up. I didn't choose to be an accountant right off the bat. I went to work in the mining industry. So my mother's, she was a strong role model. She had five children and she kept us all in line. I don't remember a minute that we weren't at school on time and we weren't at home and we were doing our extracurricular activities and there was nothing missed. I don't remember a lot of pressure from her. So I think that's what she drove me to be really strong in timing. Respect. She taught me a lot of respect for other humans, regardless of a hierarchy. There is no hierarchy. She was just strong in teaching us how to be independent. She's taught me a lot growing up, and so she's definitely a huge role model. My brothers were a big role model for me. They were in diamond drilling. My biggest reward is owning this business. We can go from anywhere from 8 employees to 34 employees. And I find it rewarding to be able to give a person a job, especially when they got a family with 5 children and they're supporting those people and I'm helping in the support of that. I'm trying to right now, with the help of First Nation communities in the area, is to do Aboriginal training. Because without reverse discriminating, my goal is to have 90% plus Aboriginal people working for me. I'll go out and I'll do 15 minutes trying to sell that to chief and council that this is what we want to do to get more people in the industry to strengthen your community. Because this job can pay up to 6 digits and people don't take it seriously that this is a job with 6 digits, but it is. I'm having a real tough time with human resources. Probably doing ROEs and job advertisements every second week. And finding those people and then finding people that are interested when we do find those, they go and they take the Common Core course, they come to work, is retaining them. And it's not because the pay's not good, it's just some people are not, they're opposed to working in the elements. Believe in yourself. That's the key. You don't focus on the past, that anything that's happened to you prior, and life is tough. It's stereotypical. It's tougher for a woman, I find. And hopefully someday that goes away. It's tougher for minorities, period. So I think that just believing in yourself, forget about that. Pull from the strengths out of those moments and use them. Use them to show people, like, look at me. That's the biggest thing that I did was nobody's going to beat me down. I'm going to be stronger than you're going to believe. I think that a lot of girls are, and still you see it today, that they're letting what young boys say to them or things that are happening at parties. You can watch movies and stuff like that. Forget about it. Take the good out of that and create a great big strength and do something good from it. So become a role model. But for a bank to approach me and say, you know what, I'm going to buy whatever you're selling. You are doing a phenomenal job as a chief executive officer and a chief operations officer. I'll buy whatever you're selling. Put together a business plan and bring it to me. And the lady that was the banker bought my first drill, which was $750,000. That's a lot of money, but she believed in me because I believed in me. And that took a long time to evolve. So I'm enjoying what I'm doing. I'm meeting a lot of good people. I'm doing a lot of different things that I would never have done before. So there's a lot of good coming out of the struggle from owning a business through certain environments, such as COVID. I find I'm surrounded by a lot of strong Aboriginal women. My nieces, my cousins. So I don't find where there's anything strong and Aboriginal go together for me, because that's all I know. I've met a lot of wonderful people here. I've made a lot of good friends. My AFI is unbelievable. They have been a huge support. I'm trying to remember when the first time I met the Métis Voyageur Development Fund and its players. They've been incredible, hugely supportive. They, whenever I have something for them, they take it on, take a good look, and they're quick to respond. Because in this industry, I have to be quick to respond to my needs. Especially if I get a huge contract, I say, I can get you a drill. I need to be able to get a drill. That's been assisted in my growth immensely. So, and made me a serious player in the industry. I can give credit to them. They're quick to respond, and like, I wouldn't be here without them. There's no doubt in my mind I wouldn't be here without them. And the Wabatec, with my backdrops, all my promo stuff, they've assisted me with grant. I've always been a huge advocate to get aligned with the First Nation communities. They do all the heavy lifting. That's what they're there for. Sitting as a kid, and my brothers are all older, the one would go to work and become a diamond driller, and the conversation would evolve. We always had sat at the table to eat dinner as a family, so five kids and three older brothers, and two of them got in the industry, so the conversation, so the linguistics was always around diamond drilling, and so retaining all that and growing up in a mining community is, I guess I came back to what I know best in 2012. It's, you'd never think I would have got there when I was younger. I thought, what am I going to do for a living? And here I am doing what I grew up knowing.